Today we're here with Paul Spain, tech futurist and the founder of Gorilla Technology. Thanks for joining us today, Paul.
Good morning.
Now, we're all excited about the 5G launch, which is coming very soon. What sort of impact will that have on New Zealand businesses, do you think?
5G really helps create this future that we've been looking forward to, where there's ubiquitous internet everywhere, so it's part of that puzzle. But really, it's a combination of technologies that are coming together that will deliver this ubiquitous internet that means we can connect up anything anywhere and at a good speed. And I think it's the speed piece that probably most people are quite excited about.
Mm-hmm.
That ability to be in a rural location, maybe well away from fibre, other sorts of fixed connectivity, but get fibre-like speeds.
With that in mind, what technology are you most looking forward to? What makes you excited?
Oh, excited. Well, I recently purchased a Tesla Model 3.
Oh, wow.
And that probably fits into that sort of category. I'm someone that hasn't traditionally been that excited about vehicles.
Mm-hmm.
But over the last few years, we've seen really all of the automakers are putting more and more technology into their cars.
Mm-hmm.
Electric is coming through, either hybrid vehicles or full electric vehicles. And then there's the aspects of autonomous driving. So being able to test out some of where Tesla are at is a lot of fun. But I'm also enjoying interactions with their cars. I was out with BMW a few weeks ago, trying out some of their latest stuff. It's quite a bit of fun to drive too, I've got to say.
And looking at the more extreme end of technology, I've been reading a bit about human microchipping using RFID chips.
Mm.
Do you have any thoughts about that? Would you have your staff, have an RFID chip planted in their hand?
It's probably not something that I would be demanding of staff. I guess there will be some organisations that might ask their staff to do that, but that's going to be in their hands. I mean, I would tend to think in most cases we're carrying smartphones, we're carrying other devices, we've got wearables, Apple Watches, mm-hmm. and Fitbits, and things like that. So the need to actually insert something under your skin, I don't think there's a need for it. There's probably a level of convenience if you want to be able to walk into your office naked and have the door automatically open, and you're not carrying any devices, then that would be a use case. But I think that would be a very, very small use case.
Yes, it seems way over the top. So is it possible for consumers to be too connected then? Like, thinking about sort of the Internet of Things, and we are wearing sort of wearables, does it get to a point where we're sort of too sort of interlinked with technology?
I'm not so concerned about being too connected. I think it comes down to our behaviours.
Okay.
And it comes down to security. Those are the sorts of things that I think are important. So it's okay having access to the technology, but if you're always spending your time looking down on the phone rather than looking at the person that you're with, that becomes a problem. Or if you're wearing technology, or you've got cameras in your home, and there's all sorts of scenarios where if you're not considering that cyber security element,
mm-hmm.
or you're utilising a product or service from a company that doesn't take cyber security seriously, then certainly there's risk there.
Is there one piece of advice you'd give to businesses that are looking to implement a new tech strategy in the workplace? Is there one piece of advice that you'd give?
I think there's a lot of benefit in stopping and taking stock of where you're at. So, with my friend Gorilla, what we often do is we help a business go through an audit phase, have a look at where are we at with technology and where does that line up with where we should be, and getting those sort of basic foundations right, and then move into a model of continuous improvement. So you're continually improving what you've got rather than necessarily looking at changing everything overnight, because there are new innovations coming through all the time, and if you try and do one massive project to change everything in a short space of time, it's much more likely to fail than doing things incrementally and doing it continually.
And is there a New Zealand business that is breaking the boundaries that you're paying attention to that's impressive?
Look, I mean, I think we've got a large number of exciting startups and tech firms. One that probably I've taken more interest in than others would be Rocket Lab, which, mm-hmm. It's just nuts what they're achieving. And when you look at the competition around the world, and there are dozens if not hundreds of companies that are trying to be in a similar space to them, yet Peter Beck and the Rocket Lab team are really overachieving. And you know, I think that's incredibly exciting. When you look behind the scenes, there's so much technology that's enabling what they're doing. If we were to jump back 20 or 30 years, what Rocket Lab are doing wouldn't have been possible. But today, with current technologies, 3D printing, and low cost chips and all sorts of bits and pieces, that enables an incredible business. But there are so many more, and I think it is worth keeping an eye on what these firms are doing.
And I've got to ask, during the Rugby World Cup, did you stream any games via Spark Sport, and did you have any issues?
I did stream via Spark Sport. My experience was pretty good, I've got to say. I think there might have been a couple of minor issues quite early on, but I think in most cases, if you had the right piece of technology and you were wired into a connection, you were going to get a pretty consistent result. But there were still edge cases of people that appeared to have all the right stuff and it still didn't work. So, and I guess that's part of the change of technology that we're going through, from the simplicity of the set-top box that you don't have to know anything about technology, it just gets installed, and the way it goes with the satellite connection, it moves to things being streamed over the internet. But it is a change that we've all got to get used to, and I would imagine most people watching this will be streaming it.
Exactly, I guess it's no different. Thank you very much, Paul. And if you'd like to hear more from Paul at the next PwC Herald Talks event called The Tech Revolution, you can read more at pwcheraldtalks.co.nz for our next event on November the 15th.